Hey everyone, it's me, TuckerSimulator2 here, and in today's video, you might be wondering why I'm talking about this, but for those of you who don't, then here I'm gonna explain. You see, the 6th DLC fighter is still yet to be revealed, and for some reason, we still haven't gotten a single Nintendo Direct, except for the last two we got last month, where they show Pokemon Direct, and Violet, and the Violet Direct, slash Sakurai's 5th DLC character presentation. And ever since we got, like the 6 new DLC characters that are coming throughout the year and 2021, you might be wondering of what characters they're still left. And what people have in mind is Sora from Kingdom Hearts. And honestly, guys, yes, I am a Sora fan. I really want to see Sora in the game just to main him. And also, really, I just want Kingdom Hearts to get represented somehow. Really, like, come on. As you can see, there's a lot of games they represented, like Dragon Quest and all those kind of characters and all those kind of series I just can't name. But if for those who are new to the whole Sora for Smash thing, well, you might be really wondering of if you guys saw the comments, you can kind of see of what has been going on. You can see that the character is really hated, and that's kind of been on me for a while now, because since 2018, I was really hoping to see Sora somehow in the game, and really, there is something I really still wish that Sora is gonna be in the game. The question is back then, is why people really hated Sora back then, and now I understand why now, but for those who are new, you might be asking the same question as I did. Like, why is Sora really hated a lot? Is he that bad of a character? Is he kind of really horrible? Well, guys, I'm actually here to answer that. So, with all that out of the way, let's just get straight into it. So, first off, you really been wondering of why Sora is getting hated a lot, because we all know how Sora is really popular, for those who are not aware. But he's being hated as a character for a lot of reasons. Well, let me list some of them. Like, I can list some, actually. Like, for being like, a Disney character. People have been saying somehow, I don't know why, but people are still saying that Sora is still owned by Square Enix. Disney is too stingy. He's an anime character. He wields a sword. And a lot of things I can't really say. There's actually a document that I actually want to leave in the description below of seeing a lot of arguments talking about Sora not being in Smash Brothers, but if you want to go for an easy answer, people are kind of treating this character like he's some sort of evil devil. I don't know, but still, yeah, this is kind of what's been going on. There's like other characters, like half of the community, Smash community, because you know how extremely toxic they are about characters they do not want in Smash Brothers, really. But Sora is pretty much the big one, because he's pretty much like the new Waluigi, really, because Waluigi, people, I don't know why people are still saying that Waluigi is still coming. I just do not get why, really. But really, Sora being, like, I don't see a problem with what's wrong with Sora. I mean, I understand, really. I actually understand of why people do not want Sora. If it's a character you do not like, then just pretty much just say it. But saying that with a huge argument doesn't work that way. I say that because you've seen how many people really just do not want any characters like Crash Bandicoot, maybe Dante, Lloyd Irving. There's they actually do want them. The most hated character yet is Sora, because he's pretty much being treated like a Waluigi, really. Now look, just let me give you a piece of advice. If it's a character you do not want, then just say it without starting an argument, because that doesn't go so well a lot, because that really doesn't go so well, really. Like, you've seen how toxic the community is, right? Because, honestly, that's kind of really, I find this really dumb, because I'm not trying to be mean. I just kind of find this really, I kind of find it sad that people are kind of a bit way too much over a character. And this kind of all started because of what's been going on with DLC, I guess. But it's also something to do with the whole Sora article of not being in Smash Brothers. And I don't know why, but in the internet, people are still talking about it. And yes, Cuphead is actually having a DLC. But I just don't see the problem with the character. The thing, and look, if you really want more proof of how Sora is pretty much not bad, and if you keep saying, because I've been hearing people saying that Sora is a sword fighter, let me tell you this, guys, in my opinion, that's just completely biased, because, I mean, it actually says right here in this document, like, saying this, this argument is very biased and subjective. Sakurai doesn't care what a character is, he'll add that if he wants. The Keyblade is less like a sword and more of a stat and in the way it's used. This isn't the reason a character can't be added. So yeah, and I know Sakurai made an article talking about that he is aware of more of a lot of Fire Emblem characters and more sword wielders. And keep in mind, that is not actually confirmation. That's just Sakurai's reasoning of how he's aware of it. That also goes the same for the whole Sora deconfirm article thing, because this has been talked about for a week now, and I've seen comments saying that Sora's finally deconfirmed. Let me tell you this, guys. Like I said in my previous videos, I actually made a video right here. I say this, that this is not confirmation. And if you want some more proof, here it is. I actually want to give a shout out to this nice Twitter user saying this. For anyone wanting to know the original context of the Sora deconfirm headline floating around, head to 26 minutes and 45 seconds in the video. Nothing was said about being the vetoed. I can't say it, I'm sorry. It was stated Nintendo approached Disney in the past, not deconfirmed. So that's another thing. For all we could know, they could have just been talking about Smash Wii U and 3DS. Maybe they could have just like talked about that Sora wasn't at a good time back in Smash Wii U and 3DS or Brawl, because let me tell you this, guys, literally everyone, and I mean, well, haters and also people who pretty much doesn't want Sora, they would do anything, and they are desperate to not let this character to not come in Smash Brothers. Let me tell you this, guys, it doesn't matter. You can't say the character can't be in Smash without any actual proof. And no, the article doesn't count because, like I said, not confirmation, just speculation and predictions. It's kind of like what's been going on for the past week because people see what they believe. But look, here's my advice. Read everything first. And then you can assume. I mean, HMK even made a video about that. Because, I mean, what he said actually has points. Even the document has a lot of points. And I'll leave this in the description below. And literally, this whole article has already been debunked right here, where it shows HMK. And there is a link to the video of the recent HMK / Sora video. So, really, guys, Sora is really getting so much hate because there is a lot of reasons why. You really are aware. You can hate the character. I mean, I'm not gonna stop you. You can say the character that you don't want it. You just can't make an exact argument about it because, like, this has been really going on for a while now. I mean, because, look, guys, the thing is, if you want all, if Sora really is deconfirmed, then you have to wait till all 6 DLC characters actually gets revealed. If Sora's not one of them, then I guess Sora's not going to be in Smash then. You have to wait until all characters are literally just like revealed. You can't just say it. You can't just say they're deconfirmed because of this whole thing. That's just all I want to say. Really, like pretty much, really. And really, I don't think people are aware of how extremely popular Sora, of how hashtag Sora for Smash is literally happening. There's been a lot of things. There's also been something talking about this whole article. But they're actually aware of that. They're pretty much that the whole article doesn't deconfirm Sora. So really, guys, that's just all I want to say. So that's just a piece of my advice. And if you didn't, and in case you want more, let me tell you this. If you bought the pass and said you didn't like the character and say it was a waste of your money, let me tell you this, that was on you, because Sakurai said this, asked what happened with Fighter's Pass Volume 1, you can only buy the pass in case you are willing to trust yourself of having fun with the characters. That's literally what he said, the same thing, like, with the Volume 2 and all that. And if it's a, and if you didn't buy the pass, if it's a character you do not like, then don't buy it. Just, like, wait till, or you can just wait till all characters get revealed, and then you buy the pass. That's all I just want to say. So, really, guys, this is just what has been going on all the time. So, really, let me know in your opinions below. Do you really think Sora still has a chance to be in the game? And do you just kind of find this a bit too much and a bit overreacting of how people just are this desperate to not have Sora in Smash Bros? Just let me know your opinions below. Just to let you know, I'm not trying to be mean, this whole entire thing, because I just find this a bit of a really huge problem about a character. That's just all I want to say, pretty much. So please do not hate on me, alright? So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell for more videos, and I'll see you guys next time. Remember this, may your heart be your guiding key.